There were acrobats. Acrobats.
What did he
One
say? Acrobats. There are two words.
was
This was me throughout primary school and a big part of secondary school. There are, of course, benefits to dictation and vocabulary tests, the main one being that you go through the thinking process of writing accurately. But what if we could just remove the negative aspects and just keep the benefits? Well, let's check it out! Hello everyone, this is Yoshihito Dharamachimamori, the founder of the Library for Multilinguals, and on this channel, I share with you tips about teaching your child to read and write in your home languages. When we think about teaching them to read and write, one of the exercises that often comes up to mind is vocabulary test and dictation, either because we don't know anything else we could do, or because we used to do that as a child and now see the benefit of it. A vocabulary test is generally focused on one particular aspect of spelling. So, for example, it could be words ending in the, with the sound shus, like scrumptious, delicious, etc. Dictations are a bit broader. It's not just one aspect, it's generally everything you need to take into account. So, whether it's spelling, grammar, so all the agreements you have to do, conjugation, you take everything into account, and your child needs to remember all the rules and apply them to have accurate writing. So the benefits are undeniable. However, the way it's generally organized doesn't really make this exercise something that children enjoy. As a child, I used to find dictations overwhelming and demoralizing. Overwhelming because I had so many things to think about and I couldn't actually think straight. And demoralizing when I was getting my test back and I could see all the red pen taking off one mark after another, leaving me with very little marks or sometimes not at all. And when we teach our children to read and write in our home languages, we have to stay positive. We want them to see the benefit of it, to have fun learning that language, to read and write, and to speak in that language. So in this video, I'm going to show you a few ways you can make this exercise, the dictation or the vocabulary test, a bit more fun and a bit less punitive. Before we start with the ideas, I wanted to point out two things. First, it is really important to go step by step. Our children are not going to learn everything at once, and whatever they are going to learn, they have to repeat several times until it sticks in their head. Vocabulary tests are generally centered around one grapheme, so a way to write a sound, or a phoneme, which is a sound in the language, and this can be transcribed in different ways, like in French. The O sound can be either O, AU, EAU, and in English, you have different variations for the sound A. We can take the same approach with dictations. So instead of asking them to think about everything, we can tell our children that we're going to focus on a few different aspects of accuracy. So it could be to do with spelling, it can be to do with adjective agreements for languages like Spanish and French, where the ending of the adjective changes according to what they are describing. And that way, by limiting what our children need to focus on, they'll be able to remember better the rules and to apply them and to practice. And this will help them remember all these rules. The second thing we can be providing are help sheets. Please don't call them cheat sheets. The wording really have a big impact on how our children see the same piece of paper. So if it's a cheat sheet, they will always be thinking that they're cheating. They can't really rely on what they've learned. They have to cheat to be able to succeed. If you call it a help sheet, on the other hand, they're going to understand it's here to help them improve. And that's how they're going to be using it and viewing it. So once they'll be more confident, they'll be able to detach themselves from it and actually remember everything that was there. So if we look at this example, it's how I've explained to my son that the letter S could be pronounced S or Z. And between two vowels, if there is one S, it's going to be the sound Z. And if you put two S's, that's when you get the sound S. And this is the help I provided when I was trying to test how much he could remember. So you can see that most of it is rubbed off, but you can still see in what place there was what. And this helps your child go back in their memory, trying to figure out what was written in that place, and that will help them remember it better. So now, let's see how you can make that more fun and less daunting. So the first way you can do that is by disguising the activity into something that has nothing to do with the test. You can use props, for example, like a phone with a thread, and instead of speaking in a monotonous way next to your child by reading the text, you just speak on one end and your child listens on the other end to hear the words. And in that way, they'll be able to write it. It's a bit less daunting. You can do that with talkie-walkies, even with your phone. You put it in, you have one phone on one end, the other phone on the other end. You put the speaker on and you dictate the words. You have loads of ways to do this. Another way you can do that is by removing the table. So it's not anymore something where your child has to write on the table, but it's a bit more active. So you can see one of my previous videos that I link in the description below, how I included a parkour to have my 5-year-old son revise for vocabulary test and do the vocabulary test later. Another way you can do that is a running dictation. So the running dictation is you have the text on one side that your child has to copy. They need to run to the text, read it, go back to their sheet and write it from memory. So this distance is going to help your child remember a few things from the spelling. And it's generally a lot of fun. The main negative aspect of dictation is really the shame that some children can feel when they are not doing well. So to remove this, you can reverse the rules. So you're not the teacher and they're the student, but you're the student and they're the teacher dictating the text and you're going to be writing. What you need to do then is to make the kind of mistakes they were doing when you were explaining things to them. And when they're going to be checking your text compared to their text, they're going to see some differences. And they want to say, oh, you made a mistake here. And you can say, oh, really? But so how do you write it then? What's wrong with that? And by explaining to you what's the correct thing, they're going to be reinforcing their understanding of the grammar rules of the spelling. So they'll be learning in the end without having to make mistakes themselves. Another activity is simply very similar. You put two texts next to each other where you have mistakes in different places. So they're nearly identical, there are just a few mistakes, and your child needs to decide which version is the right one. Which one is the mistake? Which one is the correct version? And each time they have to think by comparing two differences in the text. And again, that's going to help them reinforce the understanding without them making the mistakes. And the last thing I would suggest is to try to include in their daily lives zero at stake activities. So when I say zero at stake, I mean that whether they do it or not, it doesn't matter. Whether they make a mistake or not, it doesn't really matter. So there's not too much pressure on them. And by doing it over and over without any pressure, they'll be able to remember it better without any shame or guilt. So there are different ways. So I remember one of the first ways I've done with my son, my eldest, was letting him text my family. So I would let him look over my shoulder, see what I was writing, and I told him, oh, do you want to answer them in French? Because my family speaks French. And he said, yeah. And so I was telling him a few things. So beginning, I had to tell him quite a lot. But what helped was really the predictive text. So each time he was starting to type a word, there were three words at the top he could choose from. And I was asking him, so which one do you think makes the word you want to say? And this helped him by elimination, starting to understand how to write words. The second thing you could be doing is a shopping list. So you discuss with the child what food you need to be buying in the shop, and they're going to be writing it. And as an incentive, you can tell them that they can add a few more things like ice cream, biscuits, etc. To help them do that, you can have a list of items that you generally buy. So your child can refer back to each word and copy them. And you see that because it's a bit tedious, with time, they will want to start remembering how to write them. So they will be more prone to remembering the spelling of these different words. Once they're a bit more familiar, they might want to take on the challenge to write themselves. And the last idea I can give you is to ask your child to organize a treasure hunt. So Here, it's based on the same principle as before. You give them a help sheet that's going to have the structure of some typical sentences. For example, look inside the bed. Or go in the living room and check inside the cushion. And then write different clues that way. So because you provide them with help, they'll be more confident writing the sentences and they'll be quite free to hide everything where they want to. And giving them this power to write whatever they want is going to really help in terms of them remembering it and being motivated to write as well. I hope this gave you a few ideas on how you can make dictation a bit more fun for your child. If you want to get more tips on how to teach your child to read and write in your home languages, make sure to subscribe to the channel and ring the bell icon. Bye!